Welcome back. It's time for Health Club now. And today we're talking about pneumonia, the signs, the symptoms, and the healing, all in our Health Club.
I was phlegming and then I was coughing. And I waited for some days, tried some home remedies like drinking a lime and tea, thinking it will go overnight. It didn't. So after a week, I went to the pharmacy to get self-medication, some antibiotics and then cough mixture. And then it wouldn't go. That was 2 weeks. And after 2 weeks, it became a severe cold. After I finished taking my medication, I lost my sense of taste, my sense of smell, my sense of hearing. I was in a lot of pain that I couldn't stay home with. I was in so much pain, I had to go to the hospital. And then after I saw the doctor, I told him I had cold almost 3 weeks, and he got concerned because I was in a lot of pain and I couldn't walk. And so he sent me up for some lab tests and then an x-ray, and that was when we realized I had pneumonia.
Well, the term pneumonia actually refers to a condition that deals with inflammation in a person's lungs, and as a result of maybe having contracted an infection, it means that the spaces that the air is supposed to sit in and do its normal work or do its normal passage of oxygen to the body is now occupied by agents of inflammation, which includes fluid, which includes maybe sometimes pus. Lung tissue begin to swell up and then they are filled with fluid. So where your oxygen is supposed to sit or your air is supposed to sit, now you may have some inflammatory fluid rather sitting there. So your air intake becomes reduced, and therefore it also means that your oxygen supply to your body also becomes reduced. Now this infection is either by bacteria or by viruses or sometimes by other types of organisms called fungi or other types we call mycoplasma. These agents can be present anywhere in our environment. It means that you would have to contract it some way somehow, either through contact with somebody, you shake somebody's hands, right? This person probably has some infection already in his nostrils, he must have picked his nostrils and shakes you, and then you also eventually get it in contact with your respiratory system, and then you may have contracted an infection. Now, if it so happens that your immune system is not strong and you get overwhelmed by these bacteria or these viruses as it were, then your system gets compromised and therefore you are down with the infection. So you might start having a cough for a few days, and later on a fever would ensue. So you start feeling feverish and you have all the general things about feverishness. You have body pains, joint aches and pains, you will lose appetite, your body becomes warm, sometimes you may have rigors, you'll be shaking. And that's when you'll be tempted to think that you have malaria with a cough, but sometimes it may just be plain pneumonia you have. You get to a point where you have difficulty in breathing.
Well, I knew it was treatable, but my concern was how far along maybe I'd had an infection and how much damage it has done. I found that it can destroy your internal organs and all that. So it was about the damage it had done at that particular time. And he told me it wasn't too much damage that it wasn't irreparable. So he assured me I was going to be okay if I could only follow my medications. I needed to get well.
Pneumonia is prevalent. It's a common thing that comes to hospitals. I mean, if we look at it on a worldwide scale, children under 5, for example, about 15% of death in children under 5 is due to pneumonias. It's either they have bacterial pneumonia or viral pneumonia or any of the other types. So it's something that is prevalent. And again, it's commoner in people whose immune system is not strong. Children who are malnourished, for example, are going to be more prone to having an infection because poor nutrition eventually affects your immune strength. It also goes in tandem with people who are also aging, the elderly, above 65 years. With old age, immune system goes down and you are likely to come down with this kind of infection. Apart from age, the other risk factor may be people who smoke. Now, smoking cigarette basically also reduces the strength in your lungs. It also reduces your immune strength. Kids who have parents who are always smoking around, it also affects the kids in that sense, so that their lungs and their lung tissues are compromised, so that they can even get pneumonia. Then you can also come to traditionally. I mean, if you are living in a house where they are cooking indoors and you have all these maybe charcoal, biomass, things that are being burnt as fuels. Now, generally, it generates smoke. The kids or people will be inhaling it every now and then. All these things go to compromise the strength of the alveoli or the air sacs in your chest. If you look at our communities where you have crowded houses, one person coughs out, sneezes, and droplets are released. It circulates within the room. It doesn't go out. It has to do with one, early detection, and then use of antibiotics. If it is detected early, I mean, when a doctor should examine you or you give your symptoms, he examines you, maybe listen to your chest, do a few physical examinations, and diagnoses that you have a pneumonia, and maybe he might request to do a few lab tests. So you want to do a chest X-ray to verify. And after that, depending on what you suspect, if it's a viral thing, he has a way of managing it. If it's a bacterial thing, he has a way of managing it. And basically, it has got to do with controlling the fever and also giving you antibiotics. It could be oral antibiotics. It could be intravenous antibiotics. And where it is becoming severe, there may be the need to give you oxygen as well, oxygen therapy. When it's detected late, if you sit at home, you are not comfortable and you stayed at home for too long, sometimes you may come in respiratory failure, and that means that you either have to get into an ICU, and if there's no ICU, then you are going to have your life compromised.
Yes, I'm out of the woods, but I still have to watch myself until I can totally get well. So that also includes a few lifestyle changes. I don't drink cold things, no air conditioners. I cover up like now, even in the daytime. I make sure I don't step out too late, and I can't do too much jogging for more than 30 minutes.
For people who have what we call chronic obstructive pulmonary diseases or chronic obstructive airway diseases, like people who have lung conditions already, like people who are asthmatic, you know, changes in the weather can even affect them. So these people, they need to take a lot more precaution in terms of protecting themselves, wearing their clothing, make sure they are well protected in that sense. If you have children around, make sure that they are protected. I'm not saying that the weather being cold necessarily is the cause of pneumonia. I say that people think that when you lie on the floor, it's, I'll stop lying on the floor, because when you lie on the floor, that's when you get pneumonia. No. That is not. That is a myth that should be dismissed with rapidity. So they need to take the necessary precautions. People who are debilitated, they are in hospital, lying down all the time. They are not that much active. They don't do a much of respiratory physiotherapy in that sense. so they are likely to also come down. So good activity, do good sports, I mean, have all these things, having an active lifestyle also helps. Those who are smoking should reduce their smoking, because it's not only affecting them, but those who are not smoking are also inhaling, and in the long term you end up affecting them as well.